Tomorrow, voters also will choose a new lieutenant governor. The race between Democrat Hala Ayala and Republican Winsome Sears is just as close as the governor's race, according to the latest CNU poll.
Both women would make history with a win. The winner would be the first woman of color to serve in that role. Ayala's top three issues are tackling gun violence to provide quality, affordable health care, and strengthening education.
Sears says she is focusing on creating good-paying jobs, cutting costs for families, and to open and strengthen schools. In the CNU Wasson Center's recent poll, Democrat Hala Ayala is showing just a one-point lead over Republican Winsome Sears. Now, with that said, this is another toss-up race.
Yeah, we're going to go send over things to Mike Gooding at Virginia Wesleyan's Leslie Coggle to break down this race for us. Mike.
Well, thank you, David and Janet. Dr. Leslie Coggle, you're an assistant professor of political science at Virginia Wesleyan University. You've been watching all of these races very closely. But let's get real. Who cares who's lieutenant governor? The reality is, for 30 to 45 days, depending every other year of the session, the only thing lieutenant governors required to do is to swing a gavel in the General Assembly in the state Senate. That's it. It's really of no moment. So why is this race of any importance?
This race is really of importance because lieutenant governors have traditionally made gubernatorial runs kind of after their term as lieutenant governor is up. So I think we're seeing a lot about where the party, both parties, think they're moving in the future and kind of what sorts of coalitions they're building. I would say this year in the House of Delegates, you see that women are running at great rates. 50% of the candidates are women in the Democratic Party and about 30% in the Republican Party as well. The fact that you see two female candidates and two minority candidates is really indicative, in the lieutenant governor's race, is really indicative that the parties are prioritizing diverse coalitions and presenting diverse faces, I think, to their constituents, to the voters.
Let's talk about the candidates themselves. Winsome Sears was a delegate from the city of Norfolk back in the very, very, in the 90s or early 2000s, a long time ago, whereas Hala Ayala is a currently serving delegate. Does either one of their experience that they bring in the legislature bring any advantage or disadvantage to them at the polls tomorrow?
You know, in general, I would say that I doubt it brings very much in the way of advantage, if for no other reason than most voters aren't very kind of stuck in the nuanced details of past voting records when you get down to these races, right? I do think their experience in politics generally is going to make them both kind of better campaigners and better networked. And also, as they're preparing for gubernatorial runs, assuming that's what they're going to do, that gives them a much better lay of the land in terms of what things look like, you know, what to do, and kind of makes them better at kind of helping the governor as he's kind of going through and spearheading his agenda here.
Another important role, this is the other thing constitutionally the lieutenant governor does, is to step in if the governor should become incapacitated in some kind of way. Again, I don't know that voters are thinking of that tomorrow when they vote. In fact, I think they're probably very tribal and just voting, you know, straight party line ticket. But maybe they should consider that, right? Because this person could be governor.
Yeah, and in all likelihood, again, one of these people is running for governor. So I absolutely agree. And you would hope that voters are considering some of these kind of past performances and policy positions as they go down the line
and so
as they vote.
Going forward, heading into tomorrow, I'm here about 16 hours from now, the polling suggests that it's within, you know, a razor's edge. There's no way we're really knowing right now, is it? I mean, do you have a sense at all?
Of who wins?
Well, yeah, and this lieutenant governor.
You know what? I don't have a great sense. I'm not going to make a prediction,
of course
is
not.
What I'm going to say.
Oh,
but
I don't either. I don't make
I would say that polling gets really difficult here because what we're trying to figure out is who likely voters are. When we show you polling averages, we're showing likely voters. Part of what's up in the air about this election is who is going to turn out. And, you know, Virginians, in terms of registration, Democrats hold a heavy advantage in the state. At the same time, Republicans tend to be more likely to turn out in off-year elections. So really, this question of who wins in this race is about how good Democrats are at getting their voters out in voting in this off-year election.
Well, and one thing that strikes me, too, is unlikely voters. I think that's one thing that pollsters and we in political broadcasting might have messed up when Trump ran the first time. Was we didn't factor in unlikely voters, and they voted.
It's true. And one of the real questions in the post-Trump era is how many of these new voters or these unlikely voters are going to make a habit of voting moving forward. One of the undercovered stories here, I think, in this election is really rural voters and what their turnout is going to look like. They don't traditionally vote early. But all of the statewide candidates need turnout in the western part of the state. And what that turnout looks like when President Trump is not on the ballot is going to be an interesting question that I'll be watching tomorrow.
Okay, Leslie, thank you. Janet, David?